going to transition to questions from the audience. So, two questions from the audience. If you have any, please come over.
Hazard duty pick.
Can you hear me? All right, here we go. All right, I have a question in regards to state testing. How do you propose to address the issue of motivation? You've been in the classroom and understand the state testing, and then you know the biggest issue we have is kids are not motivated to perform on those because they don't mean anything to them. How are we going to address that?
About 2 minutes or less for each response, please. Okay, and we'll start with you.
Well, I would say that in our district, we use it as a motivational technique, on top of the testing, in that we show them every step of the way their improvement and explain to them and show them what they were learning and have them in a contest with themselves and how they could improve from what they scored last year and show the bands. Now, actually, our state standards are among the highest in the nation. And when I went to school, we were number one in the nation when I was school in California. And the standards are there. We have spoken sequence set in place. It's been there for years. It shows what curriculum and skills are developed on each level. The problem is we haven't been able to enact in the lower performing districts for our students to meet that. So the testing can be used to connect them, so that students can compete against themselves in a healthy competitive climate that shows exactly their success and how they can improve.
I think we need to really get out of testing and
what
really.
What is your plan for strengthening teaching and leadership for our pre-K child, the school system, to impact instruction in the classroom?
Leadership. That's the key word here. One of the things our teachers need is more quality professional development time. I know various districts have different numbers of days allowed. I fought hard for our one professional development day that we got before that law sunsetted. But another district I had worked with before had 16 days professional development. So there needs to be more equity among the districts and to the number of days and the quality of professional development. That will bring leadership among our teachers because they will be empowered with what to do in many undisciplined classrooms today. The number one problem that I have seen throughout the state, and I have been connected throughout the state in the union as a state union delegate, I was one of 25 elected state union delegates among 335,000 of my peers. And I found there is a difference in the lower performing and the higher performing districts. And it's pretty stark. I mean, it's pretty obvious. And it will work. We can fix the lower performing districts to be high performing, and they can be rigorous, interesting learning environments with students engaged and learning with the teachers. And that comes from empowering our teachers to start with a learning classroom environment that is with very low amounts of discipline. I work with at-risk students, and my administrators were coming in and telling me, your class is just like a regular class. It took me quite a few years to get to that, because they were the ones with all the dysfunctions, the behavior problems, the emotional problems. So I know that every student can succeed and improve. We closed the gap more so than any other district in the nation that one year. Of course, every year they give a different winner and a different set of teachers and circumstances. So it does go around from one district to another. But I want to encourage you today, if you find yourself in a lower performing district, there is a way to bring success to you, your district, your class, and your students. And I will show you how to do that because I've been in the model that has succeeded and our kids bought into the using the testing to diagnose what they knew. And it helped us as teachers to know what to teach, to take them beyond from where they were. we didn't use it as a disciplinary or punitive measure. It was comparison to themselves and what they've done in the past, and we could show them specifically where you can improve. And I've seen it work, and I know it will work for you and all.
Here we go, next question.
Obviously, state standardized tests are meant to score students' proficiencies in mathematics and English mostly in academics, right? Do you see anything inherently wrong with using those test scores to evaluate or perhaps to assess teachers? So, in other words, those tests are designed to evaluate students' academics, and then we want to use them to evaluate teacher performance and then perhaps give a merit pay or performance pay based on them. Do you find anything fundamentally wrong with that?
Absolutely. That's like saying to me, Larry, we're going to have you run against Jerry Rice and see if you can catch football like Jerry Rice. And if you do, we'll pay you as much as Jerry Rice. For those of you who aren't football fans, he used to be a great football player. That's nuts. I mean, really think about that. I mean, the idea that somehow this particular performance now is going to determine your qualities as a teacher. That's insane. And I think anybody who believes in that or buys into that must be in Palo Alto because they're going to get all the money. I promise you.
I would certainly not use that as a sole indicator. That would be unfair because, for instance, I taught students who were low performing, and for them to do as well and increase as much as some others who are academically more talented, there's an inequity in the system for teachers to use that solely. However, I think of business and how people are evaluating the business and getting bonuses and incentive pay, and I think we could incorporate a little more of that idea in it as a composite of 5 to 10 criteria that are added up on a point basis, and it wouldn't have to even be a major part of it. But there are many teachers, for instance, my students' scores were the most improved in the nation that year, in my classroom. Woo! I want that credit for them around the state. I never got one. You know, and I had the numbers. So those who do well should get that acknowledgement, but don't punish anybody when they don't, understanding that there are inequities in it, and make sure it includes a possibility for everybody to have success in that.
Thank you. All right, that is all the time we have. You have been a great audience, Kennedy. Thank you for